In this video, we will discuss converting your existing spray nozzles over to a more efficient MP rotator. We'll talk about the advantages that you will gain, what to watch for, and also what equipment will make the job much easier.
There are three main reasons you would want to retrofit a zone from traditional sprays to MP rotators. The nozzles in the spray bodies are damaged or clogged, and you want to install a more durable nozzle. The MP rotator has a double pop feature to eliminate clogging and is made with tough plastic to prevent damage in the field. The spray heads are using more water than needed or the zone has runoff. The MP rotator puts down water slower, allowing the soil to absorb it. This saves water over traditional spray nozzles. The zone has less pressure, or you need to use fewer nozzles for the same coverage. With the MP rotator, you can use fewer sprinklers than with traditional spray nozzles. As you can see, traditional spray nozzles lose a lot of water to misting and the wind. The advantage of the MP rotator is that it delivers water in heavy droplets at a matched precipitation rate. Much more of the water that goes through the MP ends up on the turf, not the case with sprays. The MP rotator gets the right amount of water onto your zone where it's intended with minimal water waste. A typical zone equipped with conventional spray nozzles applies water at up to 4 times the rate of a zone equipped with MP rotators. The spray nozzle is prone to runoff after a very short time. Although adding the MP rotator to existing spray bodies will not fix lack of head-to-head coverage on a poorly designed zone, the MP rotator will apply the water much more uniformly over the given area, thus operating more efficiently.
MP rotators are designed to fit on most manufacturer sprinklers, and they're installed relatively easy. But before you install them, you want to make sure of a few things. You want to see exactly what pop-up sprinkler it is that you're putting the MP rotator on. Does it have built-in pressure regulation, or is there no pressure regulation at all? We'll need to know these things to make decisions on which MP rotators to put where. It's very important that we know what the pressure is right here at this sprinkler. So for that, we can use the MP gauge and attach it right to the pop-up sprinkler and turn the water back on and measure the pressure right here at the head. The MP gauge is designed to fit right on top of the pop-up body. The gauge is already screwed into the side of the T, and the T is two-sided, male and female thread, so it works on most any manufacturer's sprinkler. Here's the MP gauge installed on the pop-up. I have verified that the pop-up has no built-in pressure regulation, and it's reading almost 60 PSI. The optimum pressure for the MP rotator is 40 PSI. A lot higher than that, and you will not be able to adjust the radius to your liking. While if you have real low pressure, say in the mid to low 20s, it will rotate real slow or maybe not at all. So we have to establish what is the existing pressure at the head you'll be retrofitting. If you find that the pressure is well above 40, there are a couple of ways to tone that down. If the zone is average size, you can keep the existing non-pressure regulated pop-ups in place and regulate the pressure at the Hunter valve with an AccuSync pressure regulator. Other valve manufacturers also make pressure regulation devices for their valves. If it is a larger zone, you would want to retrofit the existing pop-up bodies with Hunter's PRS-40 pressure-regulated pop-ups. To get the lower reaches of that nozzle's throw, you would want to start with the PRS-30 pop-up that is regulated to 30 PSI. In regulating at the head, you will be assured that you have proper pressure all the way to the last head in the zone. So as you can see, this zone is a great candidate for an MP rotator retrofit. We have a damaged traditional nozzle, and in putting the MP rotators in their place, with the MP's unique double pop design and more robust construction, they'll give you years of hassle-free performance.
We have several MP rotators to choose from. The original MP rotator line can be mixed and matched in the same zone because they apply water over the given area at about 0.4 inches per hour. Knowing this is important because you may find that you can put the MP rotators in the corners where you have to have a head, and you might end up capping off every other head depending on your exact head locations. The MP800SR is part of the MP Rotator SR series product line, which irrigates at 0.8 inches per hour. Since this precipitation rate is different from the traditional MP's precipitation rate, it should be zoned separately.
Retrofitting from an older spray system over to the newer MP Rotator will give you a much more efficient system. It'll save resources and money in the long run. Not to mention MP Rotators are much more robust construction than typical spray nozzles. With a little bit of thought and planning, you can have a fantastic irrigation system. For more information on the MP products, please visit us at hunterindustries.com. And thanks for watching.
If you need to know how to install and adjust nozzles, watch our MP Rotator installation video. It can be found on the Hunter website in the video library.